Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I have a new video. I'm gonna share with you my makeup collection. I mean, this video I already did like a high-end version, so that might already be up. So this is my makeup collection drugstore version if I wasn't a YouTuber. So it's like your favorite things if I wasn't a YouTuber. What were the things that I would prefer to have it in my collection? So we actually have this kit. I actually have two of these. So I usually carry these bag only if I am going on a staycation or anywhere specific. I usually carry these bag because I mean it carries a lot of stuff for just one person. So I really love this bag, and I am actually filming this video the second time because I mean I filmed it like yesterday, and I mean I finished it off, and when I actually saw the footage I really didn't like it because my eyelashes was like wonky, and I'm just looking at my face here and I don't have mascara on. I was actually filming a TikTok video and I actually forgot to do something to my eyelash. So I'll just put some mascara or eyelashes, false lashes on my eyes and I'll just be back. Oh my god, I'm feeling so much better. I really don't use a primer because I think like moisturizer make it much more better. Foundation I have like a lot, but I think I'm just going to go with two of these because I love a good luminous, not very dewy, but I love a good radiant luminous foundation, and this is the one I'm actually really loving a lot, and I would really have it in my collection. Very easy to just put in your bag and have it in your collection. It is a squeezy tube. So this is the NYX Born to Glow Naturally Radiant Foundation. I have the shade Buff. This is a very beautiful, very lightweight, and it is a medium coverage. Love a good medium coverage foundation, and I love it to be more natural, radiant, youthful looking thing. So I really love this, and they have a bunch of shades, and it is very easy to travel. Doesn't sink in my lines. My skin looks really flawless and it looks really radiant. I would really have it in my collection all the time because it is so good. And then going on to full coverage, I mean I really don't love foundations which look dry and matte. I don't really like that, and I don't like my skin to look and feel tight. So going on to the next foundation which I really love a lot, so this is the L'Oreal Infallible Fresh Wear foundation, and I have the shade 130 beige. It has a nice pump and it has some new oxygen technology, but it looks really fresh on your skin. As it says, it looks really fresh. It doesn't look matte. I mean there are foundations which look total matte and it looks flat. This doesn't look like that. It gives you a very natural looking skin and natural looking face. I mean it is a full coverage. It doesn't look matte. It doesn't sink into my smile lines, and it's really good. I mean it is a long wearing foundation and they have a bunch of shades, and it is a really good foundation. But I mean this is amazing, and I would really have it in my collection because it is actually so good and it looks really beautiful on the skin. So I really love this foundation so much. So we actually have that. And now for concealer, I have two, because similar to the foundation I love concealers for everyday and I love a full coverage concealer. So we actually have two of those. Firstly, going on to one of my favorite concealer, which is Wet n Wild Photo Focus Concealer in the shade light medium beige. This is very similar to my skin tone, and I use this concealer when I want just something on under my eyes to just cover my dark circles. This doesn't really hide my dark circles because it is light to medium coverage, but I mean it's really good for everyday. So I just use a color corrector underneath this and I'm good to go. I mean it blends so easily, dab and you are actually done. It doesn't take any effort to blend. That is why I love this a lot, and the price point is also really good. But I mean this looks perfectly good under my eyes, and I really love this a lot. So when there are days that I don't really want a full coverage, because I usually don't put on a lot of makeup while I'm going out, I don't use a full coverage concealer. I use this and I'm really good to go, and I really love this a lot. For days when obviously I am doing full makeup and I want a full coverage concealer, this is the L'Oreal Infallible More Than Concealer, and I have the shade 327 Cashmere. I mean this is a really nice color for me, even for highlighting as well as hiding my dark circles. And you know, it's a full coverage concealer and I don't really need to use a color corrector below. For the Wet n Wild one, I really need a corrector because it is not full coverage, but this is amazing, and it is very similar to Tarte Shape Tape, and even the wand is similar to that. I mean even the wand is similar, and you really don't need a lot. It is so full coverage and it will hide your dark circles, and it gives, I mean it is not even drying on your under eyes, so I really love that. And this two together, really good combo. So we actually have that. And for color corrector, if I want to use, and there is just one thing, one brand, and I have backups of it because this is the only color corrector I use. This is so affordable, and I honestly haven't even tried any other brands because I simply don't want to, because this is so good, it is affordable. So this is the LA Girl Pro Conceal HD Concealer color corrector, the color peach corrector. So they have like two types. This one is peach for light to medium skin tones, and they have like orange color also for deeper skin tones, but I prefer this because it is, I mean, this is better for me and it goes well with my skin tone. So it's really nice, and you don't really need a lot, and the applicator is also good for applying, and you really don't need to put a lot of effort, just dab it, and it really helps in color correcting your dark circles. So I use this, I mean, these two combo, I really use it a lot. So these two combo are amazing, and I would always have that in my collection because it is very creamy, it is not oily based or anything as such, so it doesn't really, I mean, it looks really good under your eyes. So I actually have that as my color corrector. I have backups of it, just that, no other brands, not even high-end brands. I don't have any high-end one. And so, now going on to powder. Now for powder, I really don't have anything in loose powders from drugstore. Powder is also really nice, and if you use it under your eyes, obviously it won't make it dry because it is so fine powder. So this is the Wet n Wild pressed powder, and I have the shade Warm Light, and as you can see, it is so fine, so it will actually not dry up your under eye. So this is a really nice powder to just set your concealer. It's really nice. It is a really nice compact powder which you can just use to set your face, and it looks actually really good and very, very affordable. And the second one which I have, and this is always there in my collection, I have backup of it because it is so good, and you can see how much I love it. So this is the Stay Matte pressed powder, and I use the shade 004 Sandstorm. Even this is very similar to that. It is very, very fine. Honestly, I just use loose powder, but if I am not using the loose powder, that is what I use. And this is a really nice powder to just set your face, so I use it mostly to just put it on my face. It is actually really good and very, very affordable. Now for bronzer, I just have one. I mean I have a bunch in my collection, but I think if I wasn't a YouTuber and I wanted something, just one, I think this is the best bronzer to have in your collection. I mean, it is a bit pricey for the drugstore point, but I think it's worth it. So this is the Physicians Formula Butter Bronzer. This is the Murumuru Butter Bronzer, and I have the original one, which is bronzer. Now they have like a bunch of shades, so you can choose according to your skin tone, and as the name says, it is like butter. It is so soft, I mean, seriously so soft. It is not warm or very, very cool tone. It is neutral, and I mean, it looks really good on your skin. It smells amazing, like coconuts, and it's worth the price. This is the best drugstore bronzer to have in your collection. Seriously, I love it a lot. It's pigmented, it's really beautiful, it looks really smooth on your skin. So I would always have this in my collection. Trust me, I would have it. I mean, it's a bit pricey, but seriously, it's worth having it in your collection. So we have that for bronzer. Now, if you know me, I love blushes a lot. Firstly, I have the Milani Baked Bronzer in the shade Berry Amours. I mean, this blush is really pretty. I mean, it is a nice, it has a bunch of golden shade, but it doesn't, I mean, it mixes up. I mean, it's a luminous blush, it is not matte or it is not glittery, it is a luminous blush, and this color looks really pretty on your skin, and it goes with a bunch of looks that you do. So it is a really, really good blush, and it is one of my favorites. And sometimes it happens like you don't really know what you want to put on your face. I really put this, and I usually carry it with me if I'm going on a staycation, which I really want to go someday. I mean, I'm bored at home. Aside from that, this is the most beautiful blush that I have in my collection, and I would always have it. It's really beautiful, it looks really good on your skin, doesn't exaggerate your pores. So we actually have that. Then my second favorite is the Wet n Wild blushes. You know, I love Wet n Wild blushes. I have like a bunch of them. Wet n Wild is my favorite brand as a drugstore, so I would obviously have that in my collection. So this is the Wet n Wild Color Icon blushes in the shade Pearlescent Pink. Specifically, is my favorite. This blush also is very similar to the Milani one, and even this has like a bun. I mean, it is also a luminous blush, it is not flat, it doesn't look matte and flat on your face. It looks really pretty. It has tiny sheen. It is a sheeny blush, and I mean it looks really beautiful on your skin, and even this color looks really gorgeous. It is not proper pink, the Barbie pink. It is more of a corally pinky peachy color, so it looks really pretty, very affordable, and if you find it on discount, good deal. So this, I would always have it in my collection because I love such colors. And then going for the last one, this is the LA Girl blushing in the shade Just Peachy. And one blush if I would want to have in my collection, which is peach, this is the blush because it is so beautiful and the pan size is also huge. This is amazing. I mean, they have like matte as well as the shimmery one, but this peach color in general is really pretty and I really love it so much. I love a bunch of LA Girl products as well, and this is one of those, so I would always have this in my collection. So specifically this color because it is really pretty. So we actually have that for blushes. Now going on to highlighters, I just wanna say two. So firstly, we have the Wet n Wild Mega Glow Highlighting Powder in the shade Precious Petal. I mean, it's been so long that it has come out. This is blinding and it looks really beautiful on your skin. It's really soft and it doesn't exaggerate your pores. It doesn't just sit on your skin. It's beautiful and it is very affordable, but it is really beautiful and I would really have it in my collection because I love a good highlighter. So we actually have that. And the second one is this beautiful highlighter palette, and this is the best purchase from this brand. So this is the Milani Stella Lights highlighter palette in the shade 03 Rose Gold. You have like three highlighters in one pan, so it is a good deal, and I think this is the best product from Milani. I don't have a lot of products from Milani, but I think this was the best purchase and best thing that I got from Milani aside from the blush. So I really love this a lot, and specifically this color, I really love it a lot. So I'm just going to swatch and show you how blinding it is. I mean, this shade is out of the world. I mean, that is too light for me. So I usually use this color to highlight my inner corners. Usually love this shade a lot. And sometimes I just mix and match all the three shades. But as you can see, they are so blinding and they are very soft. Really good. So I mean, for the price point, you get like three highlighters. So it's really good. I mean, Milani is also a little bit expensive, but I mean, it's worth it. And I would always have this in my collection, so it is so good. So we actually have that for highlighter. So we are actually done with the face thingy. Now going on to eyes. Now for eyeshadow, I have like a couple of eyeshadows. So as you know, I mean, I share this thing in all my drugstore thing. I mean, you must be bored of it, but I mean, they are really good. So these are the Wet n Wild Color Icon eyeshadow palette. So I specifically love these two a lot. First one is the My Glamour Squad. This is how it looks, and you have like 10 eyeshadows, you have two transition shades, you have a good black eyeshadow, you have a bunch of shimmer shades as well, and it is so affordable and they are really good. And I mean, the packaging is cheap, so but you can't really expect a lot more from quality of the eyeshadow. I mean, the shimmers are really beautiful, and this is really good for everyday kind of makeup, and you can obviously add like deeper tones to make it from daytime to nighttime look. So it's really good eyeshadow palette, and I would really have this in my collection, and I have like all of them in my collection, but this specifically one is really good for everyday because I love these tones for my everyday rather than just the mauvey ones. I prefer these, so I really love this a lot. And then going on to the next one, which is the Nude Awakening. This has a bunch of cool tone shades and a black shade and beautiful shimmer shades, and you can really create a bunch of good cool tone smoky looks. And I mean, you can obviously create smoky look from this, but I don't know, somehow I think the smoky look looks better cool tone, so I would have this in my collection, and the shimmer shades are really amazing. So these two palettes are really good, and they are so good for the price point as well. Then going on to a next and last eyeshadow palette. I mean, this is not a drugstore brand, it is an indie brand, but and I really want to share it with you. So this is the Juvia's Place Nubian 2 eyeshadow palette. I mean, this is also for less than £20, I think. If you look at the eyeshadow pan, it is so huge compared to the ColourPop one. I mean, this is so tiny and this is so huge. I'll just swatch like shimmer shades and metallic shades. They are simply amazing. It is so soft, it is buttery. Literally, they are very buttery. And the mattes are also like amazing. I mean, you will like use this palette for such a long time because I mean, the pan size is huge. So it's doubtful that you will be hitting pan on it soon. But I mean, if you have just this one palette, obviously you will use it a ton. Let me just wipe this off first. I mean, you have a bunch of beautiful colors. I mean, if you want to do some colorful looks, I mean, you have like blue, green, copper color, bronze color, golden, yellow color, yellow gold color. I mean, not golden, yellow color, yellow gold color. You have a bunch of matte shades. I mean, this is a really beautiful palette and I wanted to add this. I mean, be it an indie brand, but I mean, the price point is good and on their website they have like combo, so you get two palettes for a cheaper price. So I mean, this is really beautiful and I would highly recommend you guys to try out their eyeshadow palettes because they are so good. I love the eyeshadow palettes and I would really want to have all in my collection because they are so good. And obviously the pan size is so huge, so you will take like a lot of time to finish it off. I mean, that is all for eyeshadow palettes. Now going on to brows. Now I just have one thing, and I mean, now I don't use it as much because I mean, it finishes off really quickly, but I think if I wanted to have something for my brows, this would be the one. So this is the LA Girl Shady Slim Brow Pencil, and I used to use the shade Warm Brown as well as Brunette. Really thin pencil, and you get like a nice spoolie, so you can actually create like hair strokes and really fill it in. And the spoolie is also really great to spread in and just to blend in the colors. The only downside is it finishes off really quickly. This pencil is really great. It is not very creamy. It is not the dry formula. It is in between. So it is very easy to use. I mean, I really love it a lot. Very affordable. So actually have that. And now to set my eyebrow hair. This is the Essence Make Me Brows. This is the only thing that I use. And I don't have any high-end version of it. But this is the exact dupe for the Body Benefit Gimme Brow. I really don't know whether you would be able to see, but it has like a bunch of fibers in it and even it gives you a little bit of volume, so it is really nice. I think it is for like $2.50, or I mean here you get it for less than 15 dirhams, so it is really good. And I like the shade 02 Brownie Brows. It's really amazing. So these two combo, the best for eyebrows. So this is really nice. Now going on to gel crayons and eyeliner. So firstly, for liquid eyeliner, I have this NYX matte liquid liner and it is jet black. And it is not a felt tip, it is a brush tip, and you can see it is so black. And this is the best liquid eyeliner. I don't use a ton, but when I want to use, and if I am not using a felt tip one, I usually use this a lot, and it's actually amazing. It is jet black, it is a matte finish, it is not this shiny one. I don't like the shiny ones. I love the ones which are jet black, but this one in specific is really good. So this is the best liquid eyeliner, I mean, you can have in your collection anytime, and it's amazing. So, and it's very easy to use. So we actually have that. And then going on to gel crayons. Now I just have a couple. So firstly, for matte black gel crayon, so we have the L'Oreal Kajal Mushy Bold gel crayon. So it is a twisty, and I mean, I used to love Maybelline, but now I love this one a lot. So it is very, very jet black. It looks really good. It sets really quickly, but once it is set, it is set. You can't really smudge it. So I mean, it is budge proof and it is really amazing, and it stays on your waterline. I really love that a lot. Then going on to one of my favorite brown liners, this is the LA Girl Glide On gel liner in the shade brown. I mean, this is the best brown liner. You can have it in your collection, and I really love brown ones, and I also have this in my collection like backups because this is the only brown one and they get out of stock so soon. I mean, this is really amazing, and this is the best brown gel liner crayon. You can have it in your collection. It's so good. It stays for a very long period of time. So actually have that. And from the same brand again, I just have a blue one because obviously even if I wasn't a YouTuber, I would have a colorful liner and wouldn't have like yellows and greens. Blue is such a color that I mean, it goes with a lot of different outfits, and you can just have a good nice blue color. And this blue color is also so beautiful, so you can create like nice winged liner with this, and you can just use it on your eyes on its own. Now going on to mascara. So firstly, going on to mascara, so this is the Maybelline Big Shot Colossal Mascara, and that is what I have used on my lashes today. So this is the wand and it gives you a lot of volume. As you can see, it's not lengthening, but it gives you really nice volume and it is really good mascara from Maybelline. I mean, Maybelline mascaras are really good, but this one specifically is really good and I would always have it in my collection. This specific one, it's really good. Then the next one is this, my new favorite, which is the L'Oreal Unlimited Waterproof Mascara. And I mean, you can move the handle. This is the wand and I mean, this looks really amazing. It really lengthens your eyelashes. It gives you a good volume, but I mean, it lengthens a lot. And being waterproof, they have different packaging. I think the normal one is in black packaging, but this one is waterproof. But being waterproof also, it is not difficult to use. This will take you a lot of time to come off because it is waterproof, but this is very easy. Really comes off even with water, and it comes in like, it comes out like in tube form, so it's really easy to just remove this off just with water. But I mean, this is amazing and I would have these two in my collection always. So now for eyelashes, I honestly don't have a lot of eyelashes. Firstly, I just have a couple of eyelashes. I really don't have a lot of lashes because I mean, they are expensive. So firstly, I really don't have to show you, but I'll put a picture here. So that is the Ardell lashes. I mean, they are amazing, easy to use. If you are a beginner, go with the Ardell lashes because they are really very, very easy to use. Demi Wispies, the Wispies, they are amazing and one of my favorite drugstore eyelashes. So actually we have that. And going on to setting spray, first I'll quickly tell you this setting spray. So this is the most beautiful setting spray from drugstore. One is the L'Oreal Shake and Glow Spray Illuminating Setting Spray. I think they have a bunch of shimmers to it, so you have to shake it before using it. The mist is so good. I mean, it smells amazing. The spray is amazing and it is very cheap. Honestly, I would have it in my collection because it is really good. It is an illuminating one. It is not something that will feel matte on your face. I mean, I don't like things on my face that feel heavy or that will dry up my face. I really don't like that, be it anything. Really love this a lot and seriously, I would have it in my collection always. And this is the only drugstore one that I have. Now going on to lips, I have a couple of those. Firstly, lip liner. This is the only lip liner because it is so good and that is what I have on my lips today. So this is the LA Girl Perfect Precision Lip Liner in the shade specifically Sugar and Spice. So this is the shade and as you can see, the shade is really pretty brown nude color. This will look really nice with a ton of lipsticks, not red obviously, but I mean, if you want something for nude, this would look really pretty. And this is not a drying formula, it is a comfortable formula. It stays on your lips for a long time and very, very cheap and affordable. So we actually have that. Now going on to lipsticks, I have a couple and then we will be actually done for the video. I know my video is so long. The most affordable lipsticks, and I really love the formula and they are so cheap. So these are the Wet n Wild lipsticks, these bullet lipsticks, and specifically I have like two of these, but specifically I like this shade in the shade Never Nude. I mean, it is a beautiful nude color and I mean, it is a typical bullet lipstick, not mattifying, not the creamy one. It is a beautiful, comfortable bullet lipsticks, very affordable. Is also good as compared to the Maybelline Sensational, but I think I love these a lot and they are very, very affordable. So this is the only bullet lipstick I'm gonna share. Now going on to bunch of liquid lipsticks. Now I think everyone has like a couple of lipsticks in their collection because we need like one red shade, one nude shade, one brown shade, one pink shade. So we actually have like a couple of those in our collection and I would actually tell you a couple of those. So if you want, and if I would want like one liquid lipstick in my collection, it would be this Maybelline Superstay Ink lipstick, and specifically these two shades because they are beautiful. So firstly, we have the shade 60s Poet and this is a beautiful nude brown shade. So we have that. And the most beautiful and flattering red shade is the Maybelline 20 Pioneer and it is amazing. I think they have changed the formula because I think earlier they were a little bit sticky. Now they are not. They are very comfortable. They are not the drying ones and they stay put on your lips for too long. I mean, they are very, very comfortable and they are amazing and they have so many shades, like a lot of shades. So this is the only liquid lipstick I would have it in my collections. I would have lip crayons in my collection because they are really comfortable, easy to throw on. You don't really have to use a lip liner or anything as such. This one, which I really love it, and this shade I would have it because it is a beautiful pinky mauvey nudie color. So this is the Maybelline Superstay in crayon, and I have it in the shade 15 Lead the Way. This is how it looks. This is proper nudie color. This is like pinky nude color, so it looks really pretty. You have like a sharpener also to sharpen up so that it is sharp, and it is very comfortable, very affordable, and you have like a bunch of shades. But I really love this a lot, and it is one of my favorites, so I would have this in my collection so that I can just throw on in my purse also. Now going on to lip glosses, I have like a bunch of them. So firstly, a lip gloss that I would have it in my collection that I don't really want a mirror to use this gloss is the NYX Butter Gloss in the shade Creme Brulee. I mean, this is the perfect lip gloss that you want for every day, and if you specifically don't need a mirror to actually use it, because it is so good, so easy to use, and I mean, it is not the intense one, so it gives you just little bit of coverage, and it's beautiful, it's comfortable, so I would always have it in my collection, trust me. We have the Essence lip gloss. These are the plumping lip glosses, and I have the shade 01 XXL Charm. This is like everyday kind of a lip gloss, and it doesn't really have any color. I mean, it's beautiful shimmery color, and it is very comfortable. It is a plumping one, not very plumping, but a comfortable plumping lip glosses, so you can just throw it on your lips. So shiny, so I really love that lip gloss in my collection, and it is very cheap. I mean, like just a couple of dollars, so that's amazing. Now for the other lip gloss, this is one of my favorite, and I use it all the time, and this is the ColourPop Kathleen Lights lip gloss in the shade Moonchild. Beautiful nude color, and these are the opaque lip glosses, a color to it, so I mean, that's really beautiful. They are very comfortable, not sticky at all. I use it on its own, just a lip liner and lip gloss, that's all, and that's the perfect lips that I always want. So this is the lip gloss that I would always have it in my collection. Then going on to liquid lipsticks again, because I mean these are really good, so I would always want a red color and an orange color, because orange color looks really good, and I love a good bold lipstick. So this is also Kathleen Lights collab. So this is the Ultra Satin Lip from ColourPop in the shade River. I will show you how bold it is. I mean, not everyone would actually love to use and would use this color, but I mean, I would. I have used like a couple of times, but as you can see, it is so bold. Like, it is a proper orange color. I mean, orange color is not everybody's cup of tea, but I really love a good orange color, even to wear, I mean, in clothing. But I mean, this lipstick is really amazing, and the satin lipstick from ColourPop is very comfortable. And now lastly, going on to very comfortable lipsticks, so these are the NYX Soft Cream lipsticks, and I mean, I would have it in my collection because they are really comfortable, and I like these two shades, which is Khan's and Abu Dhabi. So this is the shade Khan's, a beautiful pink color to have it in your collection, and then I have the shade Abu Dhabi, which is a proper brownie nude color. Very comfortable lipsticks, and I mean, I love a good comfortable lipstick, and these two would go really good with the lip liner that I shared. But so, I mean, I would have like more of lipsticks in my collection from these specific brands and from these collections, but I just specifically showed you these because I would always have it in my collection, be it even if I wasn't a YouTuber or I am a YouTuber, I would have it in my collection. So we actually have all those for lipsticks. And now going on to last thing for eyeshadow, so these are the eyeshadow toppers from Lottie London, and these two specific shades, I really love it a lot. This is the shade that I have on my lids. I mean, it's beautiful, and it is very affordable, and I mean, it has like a nudie base to it, and it has a bunch of glitters to it, and this is specifically just glitter. I mean, these are like the Stila ones, but an affordable price. As you can see, it has a nice nudie base to it and a bunch of glitters. Then going on to the second one, which is the shade Denied. This is proper glitter color, no base to it, just glitter. I mean, these are very comfortable on your lips. You don't need a glitter glue to use these, and they are just liquid eyeshadows with a bunch of glitters, and it is very easy to use. You don't need any brush, just use your fingers and you are actually done. So I love these eyeshadow toppers, these two specific ones, because I mean, if you want to use smoky liner and you want something glitter, use this because it looks really good. And this is one of my favorite looks, and I just use a eyeshadow to do a liner and I'm actually done. And this is really the thing that I always carry even if I'm going for a staycation or something, because I mean, it really makes your eyeshadow complete, your look complete. So I always love to have it in my, I would always love to have it in my collection, these two specific colors. So if you can find it, do grab these because they are amazing. So anyways, guys, this was all for today's video. I mean, I just wanted to share this video, and do let me know in the comments below what you like from whatever I shared. Do let me know in the comment section, and I'll see you soon in my next video. Bye.